Thank you.
Welcome, everyone. My name's Nick DiBerardino. I'm a composer. I'm the chair of composition studies here at Curtis, the senior associate dean of performance studies, and it's my great pleasure to be the director of Ensemble 2021. I'm so excited that you're here tonight for this concert featuring music about the earth, music about the natural world and our place within it. Many of you know that Ensemble 2021 is Curtis's way of presenting music, great masterworks from the 20th and 21st centuries. It gives our incredible performers the chance to engage with the music of our time and some of the greatest living composers, including Tania Leon, who's here tonight. Please join me in welcoming Tania. You'll have a chance to hear from Tania at the beginning of the second half. We have the great honor of presenting a world premiere by Tania. And Carlos Pintado, the poet who wrote the text for that piece, is here as well. We want to thank our friends. Yes, Carlos Pintado. We want to thank our friends at the Musical Fund Society who commissioned this work in honor of their bicentennial. And we're so proud to be presenting it here at Curtis tonight. Before we get started, just a few words. We're so grateful that you came in masks tonight, so we will ask that you keep those on, and also that you take a moment to turn your phones off. And this is the moment where I always turn my phone off, so let me do that now, just in case. And we're very excited to present this program tonight. So you can read about each piece in your printed programs. I will say just a few words by way of introduction. This first piece you're going to hear tonight is Thundersong by Jared Tate. And this piece is about an old Cherokee tradition. For the Cherokee people, the sound of thunder is the warring of the holy people in the sky. And one of the things that Cherokee warriors will do is fire their weapons into the sky during a thunderstorm. I think you're going to hear that imagery very vividly in this piece for solo timpani. Without further ado, this is Thundersong by Jared Tate. Thank you. Hello again. The next piece you'll hear on tonight's program is by Kaisari Aho, who's a Finnish composer, and this piece was actually commissioned in honor of her 50th birthday. It's called Terrestre, which means something like terrestrial. I don't speak French, so if some of you do, you can tell me what it really means. But counterintuitively, this piece is about birds. It's not about the land. And if you've looked at tonight's program, you might have noticed that we're closing with Messiaen, and with Messiaen's Oiseau Exotique. And it turns out that Messiaen has so cornered the market on music about birds that Sari Aho felt the need to mention him in her program note for this piece that you're about to hear. And what she says is that where Messiaen is really interested in the sound of birds and bird song, she's interested in the image of birds, some other aspect of birds. So this piece that you're about to hear unfolds in two movements. The first movement is about an Aboriginal story of a bird teaching a village to dance. And you'll hear our flute soloist, Emily DiNucci, who sounds wonderful on the part, playing the character of the bird as she does this teaching of our musical village on stage. The second movement has a very different character. It's very quiet. I hear it as mysterious and maybe even spiritual. And what Sari Aho says about the second movement is that she's imagining in this movement the image of a bird in orbit around the earth, like a satellite. And I thought that was a beautiful image to ponder as we think about music of the earth together here tonight. So I will let these folks continue their excellent work. And when they're finished, I hope you enjoy Sari Aho's Terrestre. Thank you. Those of you who are familiar with Curtis know that here at Curtis we have what we like to call our all-school project, and we do that every single year. If you were here at our Ensemble 2021 concert in the fall, you heard an entire program devoted to this year's all-school project, the music of change, the music of the civil rights era, and the fight for social justice. Tonight's concert, Music of the Earth, in some ways is a preview of our next all-school project. So next year, we will bring together the work we do in the classroom and on the concert stage here at Curtis to think about these questions about how music engages with the world, and also questions about environmental sustainability. So I thought it would be interesting to take a moment to think about the ways in which social justice and music of the earth can go together, namely in the work being done towards environmental sustainability and the fight for climate justice. And the composer of the next piece, Gabrielle Lena Frank, is an outspoken climate activist. So in her work as an artist, she has made this a priority. She's written articles about it. And she has a creative academy that she uses to train young musicians of various kinds, including composers. And in the mission statement for that organization, she has baked in a climate commitment, where she writes about her interest in using music to navigate the space between alarm and inspiration as we think together about how to preserve our climate into the next century. The piece you're about to hear, I don't think was explicitly written about environmental justice, but I think it can be heard in that conversation. It's about a place, it's about a beautiful natural place and the people who live there. The piece is called Leyendas, an Andean walkabout. And the piece is very much about the Andes and the folk traditions of the people who live there. One of the aspects of Gabrielle Lena Frank's work is a real focus on multiculturalism. She herself celebrates her Chinese, Lithuanian, Peruvian, American heritage. And in this piece, she takes the sounds of Andean folk music that she recorded actually using her glasses, a microphone and her glasses, and combines those sounds and that music with the Western classical tradition to create the music you're about to hear. I think it's really compelling, and I hope you enjoy this piece, Leyendas, by Gabrielle Lena Frank.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Hey, everyone. Well, without further ado, it's my great pleasure to introduce Tania León and Carlos Pintado.
First of all, it is my pleasure to be here again with these incredible musicians, which I adore. They're very young, they're virtuosic, full of energy. So it's an inspiration to be able to work with them, with the faculty, and to be here at Curtis once more. You have seen that the program notes are very extensive, so I am not going to actually go over the whole thing again. You know, I was inspired thanks to the words of this incredible poet with which I have collaborated now for the third time. And we were born in the island of Cuba, and Carlos came all the way to Philadelphia to walk all of these streets and to get the inspiration and the spirit of this great city. And for me, not only knowing a little bit about the city, I didn't know as much. Thanks to him, I was able to penetrate the spirit that he was infusing in his words and to learn more about it, plus the visits that I have been doing here at Curtis encouraged me to really to go into a world of fantasy, but that carries history at the same time. So the only thing that I want to add now before giving a space to Carlos to say something is that I would like to convey my gratitude to Linda Riker, which is here in the audience, and she's the one that got in touch with us. And not only that, she is one of the high officers of the McCollin Fund and the Musical Fund Society of Philadelphia. So my gratitude, and here is Carlos now.
Thank you very much. I'm so honored and so grateful to be here. And I'm gonna be brief, she said it's all right. I thank you, everyone who's here, so it's quite a journey. And I always say that there's only one way to interpret the city, which is, you know, throughout music and poetry, and that translates into history. So I just wanna thank you, everybody, and I'm so honored. And like she said, we've been collaborating for 11 years, so this is a marriage of love of music.
Thank you. Thank you. Una canzone.
Well, how about another round of applause for Tania León and Carlos Pintado? Thank you again to both of you for that wonderful music. While we are accomplishing the largest stage change of the evening, I want to say a few more final words of thanks. Thanks also to Linda Reichert and the Musical Fun Society one more time. Thank you again. And I do want to take a moment just to thank the folks that make these concerts go. So I want to say thanks to Vince Ford and his entire team, the folks working in the front of house, Amanda, Ryan, and Jakob, who you saw on your way in. The people doing this incredible work behind me here, including Olivia Rainoff. That's Olivia. She's our orchestra manager. Justin Bowen, who's doing run of show and moving a chair. And also the folks doing AV tonight. We have Drew Schlegel running our audio. And Matt Huggiston and Jonah on video. So thanks to all those folks for everything they're doing to make tonight possible. More thanks. I want to say thanks to the performance faculty who coached the repertoire tonight. So that includes Don Liuzzi, Brandon Patrick George, Ed Gazuleas, Susan Nowicki, and Milos Rapisky. Yeah, Susan's here. Milos is here. Woo! And also Danny Matsukawa, who helped us coach Messiaen, this work you're about to hear. So this piece is called Oiseaux Exotiques, Exotic Birds. Birdsong was a fascination of Messiaen's for his entire life, and one of my favorite stories about that is that when Messiaen was still young, he was a teenager, he was studying at the Paris Conservatoire. One of his teachers was Paul Dukas. You may know that name. Paul Dukas was the composer of The Sorcerer's Apprentice. Many of you might have heard that on our first orchestra concert of the season. So one of the things that Paul Dukas said to his students that Messiaen definitely internalized was, listen to the birds, they are great teachers. Messiaen spent a lot of his life cataloging, transcribing, and composing with birdsong. Oiseaux Exotiques is a great example. There are dozens of bird songs in this piece, and they are from songbirds around the world, including China, Malaysia, India, and the Americas. So in the context of tonight's concert, I like to hear this piece as a celebration of that biodiversity and all those natural habitats in which those birds thrive. So as we're closing out the concert tonight, thinking about the city of Philadelphia through this beautiful piece by Tania and Carlos, as we're thinking about bird song, I was asked by Tom Weaver, who's our piano soloist, who's gonna be wearing a beautiful green shirt and gray tie tonight. He wanted me to share some words of avian affirmation. I think you see where this is going. He asked me to please say, go birds. So, yes, go birds. Thanks again for being here tonight. This is Olivier Messiaen's Oiseaux Exotiques.
Thank you.